गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज क्लास इज एड्रेस मैपिंग एंड सब्जेक्ट DCCN. सो टुडे वी ट्राई टू कवर एड्रेस मैपिंग. सो व्हाट इज बेसिकली एड्रेस मैपिंग? एड्रेस मैपिंग मीन्स इफ यू वांट टू सपोज वी नो द logical address of a PC and want to the physical address of a particular PC on the same network, then we will use some protocols and vice versa. So address mapping is done by two types. First one RAP protocol and second one ARAP protocol. So before starting these protocols, we will try to cover some introduction about that. So why we need these protocols? Firstly, we'll see what is the logical address and what is the physical address. So we see the host and routers are recognized at the network layer by their logical IP address. Means every PC has a unique IP address, and definitely it is known by the logical or IP address. And in other words, we can say packets pass through physical networks to reach these host and routers. Means every packet travel a path and reach its destination by the help of its logical or physical address. So we can say what is the logical address and what is the physical address. So a physical address is a local address. It is called as physical address because it is usually implemented in hardware. So it is also called MAC address. Generally it is 48-bit address. And in other word, we can say the Ethernet protocol, which is implemented on the NIC, that is stands for network interface card, installed in the host or router. So the delivery of packet to a host or a router require two levels of the addressing. First one, logical addressing, and second is the physical addressing. So firstly, we need to map a logical address to its corresponding physical address and vice versa. This can be done by the two type of the mapping. First is the static mapping and second is the dynamic mapping. What is static mapping? Static mapping means it involves the creation of a table. Firstly, it will create the table and then it associate a logical address with a physical address. Means table contain two entry. First one logical address and its corresponding physical address. And extra, this table is stored at each machine on the network. And a static mapping table must be updated periodically. So generally it is very less used mapping because of table should be updated periodically. So it is not possible in easy way. That's why we use dynamic mapping generally. So in dynamic mapping, each time a machine knows one of the two address, logical and physical address. Means one address it should be known. It can be use a protocol to find the other one. Means if you are using RAP or ARAP. So firstly we see working of the ARP, that stands for Address Resolution Protocol. So what is does ARP? That accept a logical address from IP protocol and maps the address to the corresponding physical address and pass it to the data handling layer. Means what is the basic function of ARP? Definitely there is a network, and a network contains various machines. And suppose host machine M1 that want to we will try to understand with the diagram like that. Suppose this is network, this is entire network, and this network have suppose 5 machines. And this is a machine for first, this is a source machine, and this is the suppose destination machine, and in between there are many more machines are attached here. Suppose this is numbering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so in ARP, firstly machine one will be find the address, physical address of the machine 2, because ARP is used to find out or map logical address into physical address. So firstly it will send a packet that is called ARP request packet that contains the three entry. First one, machine first or machine one IP address as well as its physical address, and destination machine means machine 2 IP address by which it can find the physical address or MAC address of machine 2. So ARP request will broadcasting to all over the network. Broadcasting means every request will go to the every PC. After some time every PC will check and match the IP address. Suppose packet comes here, the machine will 3 will check the IP address, but it will not match. It forward to the next machine and so on, and ultimately it will reach to last destination PC, and machine 2 will match the IP address corresponding to its physical address. So this is ARP request process. At the same time after matching the IP address of machine 2, it will send the response to the machine 1 with containing both IP address and physical address. Means we can say ARP request sends to the network with containing three entries. First one, IP address machine 1, physical address machine 1, and IP address of machine 2, as well as in response ARP request packet sends after matching its IP address as well as its physical address. So this is the structure where ARP request and response is affected. So this is diagrammatic explanation of ARP. So ultimately we can say ARP is used to map logical address to physical address. One important concept here, when we send the request of ARP to machine 1 to network, ARP request broadcasting, but in the response of machine 2 after matching the IP address and physical address, the conversation will be unicast only, because it will send only the source machine, only the host machine, only to the source machine, means machine 1. So this is all about ARP protocol. Thank you.